Hey there, everyone! This is Chef MKT, and welcome back to Let's Play Megadimension Neptunia V2. So, where we last left off, we found out that Kurome was looking for the Swirly Mask console because apparently sealed inside of it is her physical body. So when Athenojas told Kurome that they hid it somewhere, well, she went on a bit of a rampage with the dark CPU, burning everything to the ground. So obviously, it is our job to stop her. Okay, so the party that you guys voted for in the previous video was Nepgear, Uni, K-Sha, and Umio. Yeah. I can't wait to see what Umio brings to the table, because I have not used him ever. Not even in my own private time. So let's go shopping for a little bit and see if there's any new goodies that we can play with. Okay. So the Black Clover has plus 40 to attack over the Rabscuttle. And it has 1, 2 attack slots. Ooh, that's a bit of a downer. I don't think I'll be purchasing this just because of the fact that these attack slots aren't quite enough to warrant the purchase. Okay, next up is Uni, Crystal White. So it has plus 42 attack over the Railgun. And has 3 attack slots across the board. Yep, that seems like a solid purchase to me. Thank you very much. Next up should be K-Sha, somewhere down here. There it is. The Garenheart. So this thing has plus 84 attack over her current weapon, which is the snake. And has 1, 2 attack slots. Oh dear. So I think what I want to do with K-Sha is actually purchase the Hound instead now, because she has learned some new combo attacks, and I do believe because of that, she should be able to use the Hound more effectively because of that. And finally, we have Umio. Let's see here. Takizawa's fin. Fins that were made long ago by a Takizawa that's not from the sales department. We want you to guess who that is. I have no idea what the hell they're referencing here. But this particular weapon is super duper expensive and has a base power of 639 attack. Holy crap, that is amazing. And it also has 3 attack slots across the board too. So it even has flexibility. Nice. So let's see what we have to play with here. Crystal White. Ugh. Can't say that I approve of this particular model. It looks like a plastic toy rifle. There we go. Let's see here. Umio is a DLC character, so the weapon model shouldn't change. And the Hounds. Oh yeah, we've already seen this before. I really like this weapon model, it looks nice. There we go. Okay, in terms of combos, I don't think I need to change anything with Uni because she hasn't learned any new combo attacks in the standard or power slots. But what we can do is set up her rush attacks so that if she does need to build up meter for whatever reason, we have that option. Okay, K-Sha. This attack is a critical hit. This is also a critical hit. And that's a critical hit. So all that we need to do is move the 10 shot over into this attack slot. And finally, Umio. Let's see what you bring to the table. Okay. 14 hit rush attack with 185 base power. That is absolutely ridiculous. Some people's power attacks barely reach this base power. That's pretty disgusting. And this hits 10 times, and 6 times. Let's see here. 210 base power, 230, 240, 260. Wow, this character is absolutely disgusting. If you look at other characters' power attacks, I mean, Uni hits like around 250 base power or so. Nepgear? She barely reaches like 185 on average. Umio hits 260. That is absolutely disgusting. And his standard attacks are like 180, 190, 210, 200. Holy crap. Let's see here. Previous attack was standard. Previous attack did not use a combo trait. So we can probably put that there. Put this here. And then we can put Umio Bomber here. Yeah, that seems to be about right. I think we can do that. Or we can do this. Put that there. And then do that instead. So we can do this, into this, into this. Sounds good to me. Okay, so that's the party setup done. Let's actually go to the dungeon. Whoopee! Okay, so here we are at the ABXYLR Grasslands. Very subtle naming choice there, game. So as you can see here with the enemy list and the scouting effects, I have done things a little bit differently. So first of all, I've already scouted for the boss type enemy, and unfortunately, it's something that we've already fought. So that's a bit of a shame. A second thing is that the highlighted enemies is actually the second half of the enemy list, and that is because I brought in the scout effects with the enemy change. So what this does is that it will change all of the enemies in the normal encounters with something different. And usually these enemies are more stronger with higher stats, and because of that, they also will have different item drops as well. So this becomes very important when you're doing quests later on, because you may need to do this in order to get the correct enemies to show up to get the item drops for the quest that you need to do. So finally, with the hidden treasures, we just have to obtain all of the items in the area, so that should be pretty simple to do. Alright, so let's get going. Oh right, I almost forgot. There we go. Yeah, the Umeo model. He just scratched his head with his fin. That's quite cute. Oh my goodness, what a handsome devil he is. Look at that tail fin waggle. So nice. The S-Umeo, yes. Really? Alright, that's totally not going to get old very quick at all. Nope, totally not. Mami, always useful, although not as useful in this case, because of the fact that I'm going to reload the previous save after I'm done with this route. Hi there, buddy. Okay, let's see what this guy has. Freezing Beam? So it's an ice elemental attack? That's pretty cool. ZD Monsters Charge. Whoa! What is up with... Oh my goodness, what is up with this AoE? That is absolutely disgusting. Okay. I think ZD means Zero Dimension. I think that's what it stands for. Alright, let's see your other attack. Freezing Beam. Okay, so he fires ice beams from his eyes. That's pretty cool. let's see here. Oh, right, we also have attacks on uni as well that I need to show off. So we have EX Multi Blaster, a classic attack, so it hits everything in a line. I'm actually kind of worried that the EX Multi Blaster did not kill that enemy. These enemies actually might be tougher than they look. Oh. Yeah, these things are pretty tough. So it seems like I probably should take these enemies pretty seriously. Oh, we also have Twin Bed as well. Right. That's cool. Oh. So I'm pretty sure that attack there was referencing Twin B. I'm like 99.9% sure. Let's see here. Other than those attacks, we have a heal, which heals 50% of everyone that's within the AoE. Oh my god, that's actually ridiculous. Rip copper. This heals SP? That's pretty cool and very unique. This removes status effects. This is a revive. This buffs up physical stats. This buffs up magic stats. And the EXE drive. It hits one time. Oh my god. Oh my, what is this AoE? Holy crap. Alright, let's see what it does. Okay, so his EXE drive is riding on a surfboard. Alright, I approve of that game. Oh my god. This Ubio, please. Ooh, Crossroads campaign. Those enemies look a little bit different. Oh, there's an item over here. Almost missed it. Insane. Level 5 red chip. During battle, recovers HP while in the back row. Oh, that's unfortunate. Could have been more useful if it was for the active character, but what are you gonna do? Hi. Oh god, these things actually do a crap ton of damage. Okay, time to take things a little bit more seriously then. I guess those are things that we can break. Oh, guess we'll break the other side then. Oh, that's a bit unfortunate. Didn't quite line up. So here's the thing. I probably can't kill both of these enemies, but I can certainly try. I guess hitting them from behind with an EXE drive should be enough to take them out. Oh my god, those things dropped SP charges and CPU chips. Oh, flame kill. That sounds nice. Okay, so knowing that these things drop SP charges, what I'm going to do here is this. Let's see here. Ah, yes, you have heals. Please heal everyone. Thank you. And now I'm going to heal up my SP. 1, 2, 3. Perfect. Let's keep going. Hi there. Wait a minute. Oh my god, look at this guy's face! I mean... Oh my goodness, that is such a goofy face. Oh, this game. It just never ceases to amaze me. Let's see here. Freezing beam. Freezing beam. Locked on. Can I hit three of them? Ooh, I don't think I can. It's a bit unfortunate. Yeah, I can't hit three of them. Oh, well. Oh, right. We have Yuni's other attack I need to show off. Error shooter. Ooh, AoE. Circular AoE. Can I hit three of them? Don't think so. Absolutely lovely camera angles there. I highly approve. Slash wave? Hopefully this doesn't miss. Good. And now we can finish this off with a rocket launcher. Okay, more enemies to kill. Let's go tag them out. Oh dear, this actually looks somewhat difficult. I guess it's time to use a whole bunch of monsters. I don't think that reaches. That's unfortunate. Like this. Hang on. Perfect. That was super finicky. Unfortunately, that didn't do enough damage I expected, so I'm going to have to back this up with Error Shooter. I did not hit the enemy in the back. Oops, doodle. Let me go rectify that. And of course it missed. Oh, this is leaving way too many enemies up alive. Oh, dear. Oh, jeez, these things hit so hard. Well, I guess let's use the Umiya slider. Can I hit both of these? Oh my god, I actually can. That is absolutely disgusting. Wait a minute. Oh my god. Did you guys see that? On the top and bottom of the surfboard that Umiya was riding on? Did you guys see that? Okay, I'm going to have to use Umiya's EXE drive again, just so that you guys can see it clearly. Oh, these Umiya combos, please. Alright, time to get serious. I need to build up my meter. Error Shuttle should probably be good for here. Okay, slash wave. I did not aim that properly. Oh well. Guess I'll blast him with a rocket launcher. Oh god! Those things hit so hard. Okay guys, look very carefully at the top and bottom of the surfboard that Umiya is riding on. Isn't that awesome? On the top, it's Uzume, and on the bottom underside, it's Orange Heart. Oh, that's so cool. Thank you very much, S-Sha. Huh. Lightning combo that actually isn't lightning element. Interesting. Ew, Lily rank up. Very nice. So, just to let everyone know, the reason why I haven't posted videos for the past couple of days is that I've been trying to catch up on my thesis, so I got a little bit behind on that, unfortunately. Anywho, so we have the save point here and the event flag, so I guess what we can do is... Wait a minute. Okay, I missed the item. Let me go grab that first, then I'll go make a save, and then we'll do the boss. Use this mech. And that's the hidden treasure. Where is it? It's all the way at the beginning. Great. Alright, well, let me go make a save real quick, then we can go take on the boss. And saved. Alright, I think we are all ready to take on the boss, so let's go. Whoopee! Oh, okay. Well, that was one hell of a greeting, wasn't it? Titan, nice reference there. What the hell was that? It feels like they're referencing something here.
Baka yaro! Sore wa server down no jimon da! Sore, どこぞの城に伝わる滅びの言葉だから。
いや、ネットスラングだろ。
Okay, they're probably referencing multiple things here. Unfortunately, I have no idea what they are. Hey, Nepki, taking charge. That's cool.
Oh, Megami-sama to Gold Sard が来てくれたぞ。
Uhyo! Ramu-chan to Ramu-chan はいつ見ても可愛いな。やっぱり Megami 候補生は最高だぜ。
Hey there, guy. Probably not the best time to comment about that.
極限状態とはいえ、ここまで来るとはもはや末期ね。
いや、それいつものことだから。
どうやら町にたどり着くまでに間に合ったみたいだね。
だが、どう戦う？あの時はうずめがいたが。
それなら大丈夫です。娘さんがくれたこのシェアクリスタルを使えばシェアリングフィールドが展開できるはずです。
Ah, that's right. Uzume gave us the share crystal for this. This will be very useful. Now's the time to use it.
はいはい、それ私やってみたい。
Wait a minute. This BGM. Something's about to happen.
ラムちゃんずるい。私もやりたい。
二人がそんなことを言うと、なんだかお姉さんもやってみたくなってきたな。
Oh no. Oh no.
じゃあ、せっかくだから私も。
I see where this is going.
わ、私もいいですか？
お前ら。
Well, it seems like S-Sha is the only one not interested in activating the sharing field, huh?
私もやってみたいのに、他にもこんなにいるよ。
あんたもかい。あん、どうしてあんたはこうもめんどくさいのよ。出しなさい、私がやるわ。
Wait a minute. Maybe this is Yuri's plan in order for her to activate the sharing field. It's a trap. It's a trap, Nepki.
シェアリングフィールド点火。
Oh my god.
そうはいかないぞ。
This game, please. Oh my god, get wrecked, Yuri.
はい、イーシャ。
Oh, イーシャ。
シェアリングフィールド展開。
And she even has the sparkles. Very nice.I knew it! Yuri really did want to do the sharing field as well.
I knew it!
私に言うな。いいじゃねえ。珍しく強引に表に出てきたと思ったら。
私、一応このルートの主人公なのに、この扱い、あんまりだよ。
There it is! Nepki got bullied again! Yeah! My favorite part of the game.
まあ、元気出しなさいよ、ネプギア。そのうち、きっといいことあるわよ。
Yeah, sure. You keep believing that, Nepki.
そういうユニちゃんも騙そうとしたよね。
She totally did. She tried.
あれは騙すとかじゃなくて、その、欺くというか。って、いつまでもいじけてないの？ダーク女神もわけわかんない展開で気まずそうな顔してるんだから。
本当だ。ダーク女神でもあんな表情っていうか感情アイコンつくことあるんだ。で、そんなことはどうでもいいの。フィールドが消える前に倒さないと。
That's probably a good idea. Oh jeez, this game. Just when I thought it could not surprise me anymore, it pulls one of these. Oh my goodness. That was so hilarious. Okay, so I think what I want to do here is to have K-Sha and Umyo go one side, and then have Nepgear and Yuna go the other side. Alright, first up, buff up my physical defenses on my K-Sha, because she cannot take hits whatsoever. And Yuna's also not that great attacking damage either, but she does have her own buff as well, so that helps a lot. Ow. Well, let's start building up some meter. Oh, we don't have many choices here, do we? I guess we'll have to go with Nepgear then. Let's start piling on some damage. Twin bit, go! Time to move K-Sha over around this side, and then we can attack the sword. Jump over to this platform, and, EX Multiblaster only hits 3 times. And Erashuta hits 4 times and does more damage. So obviously I'm going to pick this thing. Time to move Umyo around to K-Sha, and then I guess I could... Oh hey, this hits 10 times! That's pretty good for meter building. Hop over around here and transform. And let's summon another Nepgeardon. Okay, now because it turned around a little bit, we have to go around this side. I think that's not going to reach the sword, although it's really hard to tell. Let's go test it out. Alright, transform first. Fire the twin bits. Okay, so we did hit the sword. Excellent. Let's switch around this side, and then hopefully we can also hit the sword from this platform too. That would be ideal. Let's abuse this. Nepgeardum, Nepgeardum. Our HP levels are just fine as it is for now, so I think I'm going to use this opportunity to do some more damage to the sword. Nice. Let's blast it with a rocket launcher this time. Nice. That actually looked pretty cool. Oof. Well, that's a bit unfortunate. I think what I'll do is I'll just work on this side of the body. Let's see here. EX Multi Blaster, let's go. Oh, I forgot to transform. Oops. That's fine. Let's see here. I don't need that much more meter, do I? I don't think so. What I'm more concerned about is keeping my K-Sha and Umio alive for this. Rocket Launcher, let's go. Oh, time to heal up. Good to go. Ew. And now we can attack the sword again. Hooray. I don't think I need to buff anymore. I think I'm just going to go for it. Just go straight into Aero Shooter. Bit combination? Sure. Let's use that meter. Okay, that last bit of the attack animation there looks hella janky when using it on a giant target. It looks like we need to break the sword part again, so let's keep going. Oh, that's not too bad. Now the question is, I don't think we can actually hit the sword from here, but we can try. Yeah, that's what I thought. So I guess what I'll do is head back to this platform, and then we should be able to hit the sword from here. Ooh, EXE Drive? Sure. Oh, nice! Break both of the sword parts. Sweet. I guess we don't have to worry about that anymore. I should probably heal Uni, shouldn't I? Unfortunately, I don't think this is gonna reach. No. In that case, I'm going to use an item. Here you go. Yeah, that didn't do anywhere near as much damage. Let's see here. Let's summon another mech. Okay, I'm directly in front of it, so I should just attack it to build up some more meter. I need to make sure that Umio is always next to someone so he's ready to heal them up. She literally just claps me. I guess I can attack it from behind. Sure, why not?
Killer Soft! Ikke!
And I suppose Bit Combination should finish off this fight. I'd be really surprised if it doesn't. Oh hey, we broke everything! Sweet! Alright, so that fight went pretty much perfectly. That rarely ever happens with me. Oh hey, Nitro Plus finally got her EXE drive at level 42. Nice. Hold a fork. Ah, appears to be a debuff. Interesting.
さて、ダーク女神も倒したことだし、ひとまずイーソンさんに連絡は。あれ、イーソンさんがどうしたんだろう。気になってかけてきたのかな。あ、もしもし、イーソンさん。ちょうど今ダーク女神を倒した報告をしようと。大変ですね、ペギアさん。うずめさんに例のゲーム機の隠し場所がバレてしまったんです。
Of course she did.
で、ゲロったのはアフィモージャスとステマックス、どっちなんだ？大方、薄い本でも積まれたんだろう？
No, they wouldn't do that. They're total bros.
いえ、あの二人ではありません。教会の職員たちが悪夢によって情報を引き出されたみたいなんです。
Damn. Well, it looks like Kurama was pretty busy, huh?
すまん、二人とも。まあ、けど、しょうがないよね。 見た目はいいけど、中身があれだし。今から例のゲーム機が隠された場所の座標をNギアに転送するので、急いでそこに向かってください。
Oh! Let's see here. Oh, hey, is this Dungeon Tower set? Nice! Ooh, can't wait to explore that area. Okay, so let's fix up a few things over here. Build a route. Perfect. Check out the scouts. Okay, I did not expect there to be actually another boss type enemy in this area. That's a shame. Oh well, too late now. Ah, right. What was the hidden treasure here anyway? Energy main. Great. Thanks, game. Okay, so looking at the time here, I think this is a good point to end the video. So once again, feel free to comment below on the party members that you want me to use for the upcoming dungeon. So thank you very much guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time, whenever that may be.